una catapilla, como mi folla.
Cochi café, cochi café, no la fancy, cochi café.
A cuando?
Mola, cette fois tu m'as somnifié. Mon amour, je te l'accorde, instantané. Prends-moi en entier. Mon bébé, ne laissons rien tomber.
Guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to fake 4C hair. So I'm just going to go straight into the tutorial. Those were my pair of needles. This is my scissors. Here's thread. There are two different kinds you can use. Nylon is better than cotton. Cotton gets stuck all the time. Here's my packet of hair. It's synthetic hair from Noble. And there's my wig cap. Yeah, a pair of stockings. I'm sure you'll be wondering what I'm doing with it, but today I was thinking the other day, I was like, I want to do a wig, but I don't have a wig cap. I'm lazy to go out and find it. Then I was like, okay. I asked my mom, she gave me this idea, and I was like, fine, let me just try and do it. So yeah, I am doing it. It's a 2-in-1 video. Oh, actually 2-in-1 because it's also styling. So there, I just showed you where to cut it, and then you just cut off that part and you sew it to close the hole. It's pretty much basic. And if you do not know how to sew, it's simple. You just put in the needle and then you take it out and you move ahead, like you move forward as you're doing the taking in and out. So I'm just going to sew that down. When you reach the end, you have to cut it and then you tie it down. I'm going to keep on sewing again. Like I said, cutting threads always gets stuck. Anywho, I'm done now. I'm just going to cut off the excess parts to make it nice and flat. I'm going to flip it over and then start to proceed into the wig tutorial. Using my eyeliner, I'm just going to mark. Originally I wanted a side part, but at some point I changed my mind, so you see that throughout the video. Right now I just marked the side line where I wanted it to be. There, I'm going to sew from ear to ear. This mannequin head does not have ears, but you know, and also in case you're wondering why I use this mannequin head, this one is already customized to fit my head size while the other one is not. If you're wondering on how to customize the video, I'm going to leave a link in the description box down below. Right now I'm just going to sew. I hope you can see what I'm doing well. I'm really having difficulties in doing this. Please forgive my hair, I just washed it, so I'm letting it air dry. I'm going to show you a smooth technique on how to keep your wear strong. When you sew, you have to come back towards the end and then secure it with the double loop. Okay, that's what I just did now. And then you see me doing it throughout the video. There is the same process again, just double loop. I sewed some tracks down off camera, so I'm just going to show you some parts because I wanted it to be detailed. I did not just want to, you know, come back and show you the whole wig when it's done. Right now I'm using my curved needle. Like I said, I got needles from Household Kissed. I'm going to link it down in the description box. And it's advantageous because it comes with 12 different needles. So if you craft, if you sew, if you do whatever you do with needles, you're going to have a variety of needles to pick from. Plus it comes with a thread picker. Right now I'm just sewing. There's actually no way to sew it. There's no right way. I'm just sewing through the track and onto the recap. Try to avoid, because my recap has a bit of clothing to it, so just try to make it light so it doesn't attach itself to the clothing. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying, but I hope you do. I'm just sewing from ear to ear again, like I said. Oh, that was a sleepover method. I'm going to be showing you a more detailed one up ahead. You have to sew the tracks close to each other so it doesn't really come out as fake, because when you wear it, it's still going to stretch and you don't want people seeing the parts where you did not sew. I don't know if that makes sense, but I don't really like it, you know, like somebody's wearing a weave and then you can see where the tracks, you can see the demarcation of the tracks. It's not nice, it's not attractive. So try to sew down closely as possible. Yeah, I'm just going to teach you how to layer your tracks, like to continue. You layer it, or you just sew on top of the other one and then you attach it to the recap, then you just sew normally as you've been sewing other tracks. So right now I'm going to stop going from ear to ear because I want to create a certain bulk at the needle. So I'm just going to go fill in the back space. And there my sleepover method again. I'm just going to keep on sewing and looping it so that it becomes secure. As you can see, I'm just going to fill the back space. I'm not really doing from ear to ear. Okay, so to do the sleepover track, when you reach towards the end, you have to secure it down with the double sewing and then you tie it down. And when you flip it over, you have to sew it to the cap before you flip it over. And then you sew it down like you've been doing with the rest of your tracks. This is just repetition of how I lay my tracks together so that like I overlay it so you don't see where one track ends and where the other one starts. It makes it neater. Okay, towards the end here, I'm just going to continue going from ear to ear so that I form sort of like a U @EUpad. I do not have any videos on EUpad yet, so you could just search on YouTube. But I think this is pretty much explanatory. When you reach this part, you just go back from ear to ear. Be careful, you always have to do short tracks and you don't have to make it lengthy so that your wigs could stay for long, especially if you're going to be combing or brushing it. Okay, so there's the U part I was talking about, and then now I'm just going to go horizontally and sew my tracks to cover up the front, and I'm just going to layer them on each other. Like I said, you put them closely together, so when you try to open it, you're not actually going to see the demarcation, or you're not going to see the space between your tracks. Okay, so now I'm just going to close the wig by cutting out small 1-inch width, and then I'm going to sew them vertically. I'm going to sew them side by side, like, I don't know, you can see the rectangle there. So I'm just going to sew them at each end till there's like small space in the middle, and then I try to close it off by just sewing it down. Like I said, sew them close to each other. I'm just going to show you that. I hope you can see what I'm trying to show you. And then I'm doing sort of a circular motion. There you can see. So my hair is dry. I'm just going to use some hair oil to oil my hair. And then I'm going to comb all of my hair to the back. Using a rubber band, I'm going to tie all of my hair behind. And using a wig cap, I'm just going to wear it down so that my hair lays flat and nice under my wig. I'm going to wear my wig. As you can see, it doesn't look nice at all. I don't like the way it looks. So I'm just going to take a comb, and then I'm going to comb it out a little bit. And I'm just going to comb it everywhere. Make sure to hold it down and comb it to get the volume I want. So right now I'm just going to go for, you know, like thick fuzzy hair, because my hair is not natural. I relax my hair sometimes, so once in a while I just want to look natural. So I think I'm going to use this wig during this moment. If you're watching this video now, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you can get notifications when I post videos. And don't forget to like, share, comment. Just let me know what you think about this whole video down below in the comment section. Right now, I'm just going to take the scissors and cut some areas, you know, try to shape it down. It look nice, and then I'm going to be posing. So thank you for watching. I love you. To the next video.